Hey guys, welcome to this math and music video. In this video we're going to be talking about an Algebra 2 concept, which is solving radical equations, and the music today is Congratulations by MGMT. So the most important thing to remember when solving radical equations is to be checking for extraneous solutions. And an extraneous solution is a solution that you get when you solve the problem that doesn't actually work for the equation. So at the end of this example, I'll show you what that really means. So for this first example, we have the square root of 4x minus 3 minus the square root of 9 minus 2x equals 0. So the first step I'm going to take is I'm just going to add this square root of 9 minus 2x to both sides so that we have 1 radical on each side. So I'm going to end up with the square root of 4x minus 3 equals the square root of 9 minus 2x. And then from here we have 2 radicals, one on each side, and to get rid of those we can just square each side. So this is this side squared and this side squared, and we're going to end up with 4x minus 3 equals 9 minus 2x. And now we have a pretty comfortable looking equation that's really just basic algebra, so we can add 3 to both sides. We'll end up with 4x equals 12 minus 2x, and we can add 2x to both sides. We'll end up with 6x equals 12. And lastly, we'll just divide by 6, and we'll end up with x equals 2. But the thing is, you're not done. Like I mentioned in the beginning, you need to check and make sure that the solution you got is not an extraneous solution. So I'm just going to separate this into two steps, and we're just going to plug x equals 2 back into our original equation to see if we actually get 0. So we're going to have the square root of 4 times 2 minus 3 minus the square root of 9 minus 2 times 2 equals 0. So, this is the square root of 4 times 2, which is 8, minus 3 is 5, so this is just the square root of 5 minus the square root of 9 minus 2 times 2, which is 9 minus 4, which is 5, and that does in fact equal 0. We have the square root of 5 equals the square root of 5, and so we know that x equals 2 is a solution. So that's how you would go about solving a problem like this. Let's go ahead and do one more radical equations example. Okay, so in this example we have 3 plus 2x equals 3x plus the square root of the quantity 21 minus 2x. So the first step is you want to get your radical, which in this case is the square root of 21 minus 2x, you want to get it isolated on one side. So we're just going to subtract this 3x and move it over here. So we're going to end up with 3 minus x equals the square root of 21 minus 2x. Now to get rid of the radical, we're going to square both sides. And we're going to end up with the quantity 3 minus x squared equals 21 minus 2x. So from here it's pretty evident we're going to have to do some foiling. This is the same as 3 minus x times 3 minus x equals 21 minus 2x. So you're going to foil that out and distribute it. You're going to end up with 9 minus 6x plus x squared equals 21 minus 2x. And then some basic algebra. We're going to add 2x to both sides. We're going to end up with 9 minus 4x plus x squared equals 21, and then we're just going to subtract 21 from both sides, and we're gonna get negative 12 minus 4x plus x squared equals 0. I'm just gonna rewrite this really quickly as x squared minus 4x minus 12 equals 0. Sometimes it's easier for us to think about quadratics in this form. From here we have to factor to get our solutions of x. We know when we factor, we need to find what two values can multiply to make negative 12. So we know from negative 12 we can get plus or minus 3 times plus or minus 4. We can do plus or minus 6 and plus or minus 2. And we can do plus or minus 12 times plus or minus 1. In our cases, so that we can also get a negative 4 when we add or subtract these together, we're going to have to end up using plus or minus 6 and plus or minus 2. So our factor is going to get set up like this. We're going to have an x in front. We have no coefficient, which is great. So we know we're going to have an x and an x. And because there's two negatives, we're going to end up with a plus and a minus. And because of the way we have a negative 4 and a negative 12, we're going to have a negative 6 and a positive 2. So, once we have that all factored, we know that we can get out of this term, we can get x equals negative 2. And out of this term, we can get x equals 6. So now what we have to do is we have to test these solutions to see if they are extraneous. So let's separate this, and let's test for extraneous solutions. So first, let's start with negative 2. We're going to get 3 plus 2 times negative 2 equals 3 times negative 2 plus the square root of 21 minus 2 times negative 2. We can simplify this. This is 3 plus 2 times negative 2, which equals negative 4, and 3 plus negative 4 equals negative 1. 3 times negative 2 is negative 6, plus the square root of 21 minus 2 times negative 2, which is negative 4, so this is the same as 21 plus 4. Let's add 6 to both sides. We'll end up with 5 equals the square root of 25. We end up with 5 equals 5. So we know that x equals negative 2 is the solution. Now we're going to do the same thing with x equals 6. So we're going to get 3 plus 2 times 6 equals 3 times 6 plus the square root of 21 minus 2 times 6. We're going to do some simplifying. 2 times 6 is 12, plus 3 is 15. 3 times 6 is 18, and plus the square root of 2 times 6 is 12, and 21 minus 12 is 9. So we can add 18 and root 9. 18 plus root 9 is the same as 18 plus 3, so we get 15 equals 18 plus 3, which is 21. And 15 does not equal 21. So we know that x equals 6 is not a solution. So for this, we only have one solution, and it's x equals negative 2. That's it for this video. Please let me know if you have any ideas for things that you would like to see videos on. And I hope this was helpful. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you.
Fast, but I tied my boots to a broken mast.